I'm Kevin Phillips, and you're watching Mariners TV.
Johnny came from 2 down to win 4-2 there against Chester City. It must be a great feeling.
Yeah, great. I think the lads showed great character today. We give them 2 goals, you know, that was a disappointing thing. You know, like we give to Northumbria 2 goals. I spoke to lads before the game about this. I said, we've got no problem in scoring goals. We never have all season. You know, we need to stop giving stupid goals away. And I thought to myself, I couldn't believe the goals that we give away after I just spoke to the lads before the game about that. But yeah, to score four goals away from home, we should have scored more. Barry, with a penalty, but we should have been coming away 5-0, to be fair. Apart from the chances we've given them, they've had a couple of balls in the box set pieces, but Nicky hasn't really had much to do. So disappointing, obviously, that we conceded the 2 goals, but over the moon that we came away from home and scored 4.
He didn't start too badly, did he? But it was like out of the blue, the 2 goals, wasn't it? It seemed to inflict on yourselves.
We did it. Like I said, exactly the same as Team Northumbria. I thought we started the game really well. I mean, down the right hand side, we had 4 or 5 balls crossed in, and we didn't get a crossover man once. No. They have 1 break, you know, in the first 10 minutes. Ben Ryden gives it a free kick away against a difficult customer, the number 9. I thought he was a good player, and then they get the free kick and they put the ball in. First chance, their man gets across our man and they get a penalty. So you're thinking, we've had 4 crosses from the right hand side in the first 8 minutes, we haven't got a man across once. They go and get a free kick in the box, they get a man across once and get a penalty from it. It's, you know, so you're scratching your head.
You got your goal, got a goal back in. It was a bit of a controversy, wasn't it? I mean, they seem to call it off and then...
To be honest, you know, I don't normally call official, but the referee was really, really poor today. I don't know why they went over at the far side for 3 or 4 minutes, you know, to make a decision. I don't know if they're saying it was a foul on the goalkeeper or offside, but I think they were saying offside, but it was impossible. You know, Chrissy Roos hit the ball from 60 yards, you know, and as the ball's travelled, Stephen Ramsey's made his run. He can't be offside, you know, and the ball's went directly in. It wasn't like it came off a bar or whatever and went in. You know, it was Stephen Ramsey putting it in. The ball's went directly in. It's impossible. I'm just thinking, you know, that summed the referee up today for me.
But then after half time, James Talbot got you level.
Yeah, I mean, obviously we changed things, you know, we changed the system. We went 3-5-2, we just matched them, you know, and it seemed to work. You know, we had a little bit more energy, and yeah, we got the second goal right on just after half time, which is a great time to score. You know, we're back in the game, and then from then on it was only going to be 1 minute, to be fair. You know, we scored a couple of great goals after that, you know, and they obviously got the penalty. We should have won by more goals, but you know, after giving the opposition a head start, normally you don't come away from home after you've given the opposition a head start. You don't normally come away from home with a win. But that's credit to the lads, you know. They've dug in, they've dug deep, and the second half performance was fantastic. Great character from them, you know.
You just looked like you were going to score every time you attacked in the second half.
Yeah, we did, you know. I mean, the 3-5-2 looked good, you know. I mean, you've got big strong lads. I thought Michael Turner again was excellent, you know. Chrissy Roo, 37-year-old, fantastic again, you know, put another great shift in. But I said, lads, before the game, let's play in their half. And second half we did, you know, and we looked a real threat, you know. We soaked things up, and on the counter attack, I thought we were fantastic. I mean, Paul Kane, we left him on the bench today. He said he was struggling a bit, but he's came on, he's been fantastic, scored a great goal, you know, with his left foot. I'm thinking to myself, was he really off sorts with an injury, because I thought he was fantastic. Stephen Ramsey, how brave was he for that goal? Paul Kane, great centre forward player from the front two. You know, Paul Kane breaks out wide, gets a ball from James Talbot, puts a fantastic ball in. Stephen Ramsey's nearly knocked himself out with his desire to get on the ball and score that goal. I think he banged his head on the post, you know. It's great desire and great forward player from the front two, when you've got one forward crossing the ball in and the other one's getting on the end of it. But yeah, I thought we were fantastic. Barry Smith, Lee Maitland, you know, you can go on. You know, everybody was fantastic. It's just disappointing, you know, them first 2 goals that we've given the opposition. You cannot give opposition goals and expect to win. Luckily for enough today, we've been fantastic on the attack, and that's why we've won the game.
And Ramsey showed a lot of desire these last 2 games, hasn't he? I mean, he's been out of the team for a bit, hasn't he? But
he has. I'm over the moon for him. I mean, to be fair, Stephen, he gets lots of niggles and whatnot because of the kind of player he is. He's brave as a lion. He puts himself about. Some players would miss out on games, you know, through niggles and whatnot. He wants to play all the time, you know. And I spoke to his dad as well the other day. I mean, he works on a cold floor in a garage, so it's quite hard for him to recover. And for Stephen to play again, you know, today after Tuesday night's game, it's credit to him, you know, that he's getting through the pain barrier. He's getting another goal, which was fantastic.
And you're getting some good momentum going now in the league as well. You're closing in on Chester Street now, not far behind them.
Yeah, of course. I mean, I said to the lads, you know, I mean, I've given a little target in the dressing room. I'm not going to tell anybody what it is, but I've given everybody a target, and then there's no reason why we can't go on that on the run that I've asked for, you know. you said you've brought good players in, you know, Ben Ryan, first division player, Michael Turner, first division player, you know, you've obviously got Chris Renshaw, who's back for the next game, he's on holiday, he's going to be back, the squad looks really strong, you know, and that was the key today, that was the key, you know, you've got a good squad there, you know, could bring good lads off the bench, Alex Kempster, Paul Kane came off the bench, and yeah, done really well, you know, really well, really, really pleased with the way that things are going at the moment.
And other than those two goals, you looked quite solid at the back, didn't you, today?
Yeah, definitely, apart from the two goals we conceded, you know, I thought the lads at the back done very well. You know, Ben Ryden gives a great experience, you know, Aaron Byrne I thought was excellent again today. Chris Locke, when he went at the sweep, but excellent. I thought the lads done really well, apart from the two goals that we conceded, you know.
Mm. And Nicky Lawson in goal, solid performance.
Yeah, Nicky, I mean, he had some high balls you put on him, you know. We give a lot of free kicks away around the edge of the box, so he's had to come for things, but his handling was fantastic. Big, strong lad, you know, he's a proper goalkeeper, again another first division goalkeeper, loads of experience, you know, we've got quite a few lads who've played in the first division, and to be fair, it showed there today. I thought Nicky was fantastic in what he had to do.
And Baptiste was one of three that he came on, wasn't he?
Yeah, Baptiste was the other one that came on, you know, and you can see what he's pleasing on the eye, you know, he gets the ball, he keeps it, you know, he looks cultured. I mean, the lad's obviously from France, you know, he looks like a cultured football, you know, and I had no hesitation to put him on there today. You know, I spoke to the Durham City management and they said, you know, he likes a tackle, you know, he's competitive, you know, but he can also keep the ball, keeps it very well. I just want to get some more games on his belt so his fitness levels increase, you know, because if there's one thing you maybe think, you know, when the game's got quite a high tempo to put somebody on, you know, like that, it could go against you. But I thought when he came on, he done very well, you know, and all I said to a few of the lads, you know, even the two subs that didn't get on today, Gary Cruttle and Adam Ward, you know, it's part of a squad, you know, we need to keep yourself ticking over. If you're not playing, get yourself to the gym, keep yourself ticking over, because we're going to need people, you know, we've got 11 games left, plus obviously the semi-final and hopefully the final. We're going to need everybody running in the same direction, so yeah, hopefully everybody that hasn't played today will go and do a bit themselves.
James Talbot as well, he's really tireless, isn't he? He never stops running. Another goal there, 10 for the season, so.
Yeah, he's done really well. I mean, me and Dave Hall pulled James about 2 weeks ago, you know, and just said, listen, you know, the player that you are, I mean, Dave was obviously commenting, says, because I told Dave Hall a lot about James Talbot. I says, the player he is, Dave, you'll be over the moon when you see him play. And Dave had a word with me, says, I've heard lots of things about you going short. And to be fair, the last two or three games he's been excellent, you know. He was really good the other night against Burnley, you know. He got a goal, and he's done really well again today and got a goal. He keeps the ball well. He's a proper footballer. He likes to get in between the lines, which we've tried to play him. You know, that's why he started today, just behind the front man. But yeah, clever footballer, and I'm happy for James. He had a couple of good performances of late, which is only going to do well for his confidence, you know.
You've got Washington next up, that's going to be a real test, isn't it, right up there?
Yeah, I think Washington's what, second or third, mm-hmm. You know, one of the promotion favourites, but you know, to set the lads in the dressing room, if we can stop giving teams goals, we'll always score, you know, and I think if we can perform like we did second half, you know, we'll be a match for anybody, you know, so I'm not scared of anybody in the division if we can put a performance in like that, you know. It's just the other thing which is a bit worrying, where we've given two goals away, if we can stop that, we're a match for anybody.